Hi. If you're a patient and have gone through many attempts at conception, possibly at multiple fertility centers, think about the possibility that you may have what was only recently discovered, the so-called hypoandrogenic PCOS phenotype. Here, in short, what may be the signs that this may be your diagnosis. If you have unusually high AMH, antimullerian hormone levels, either for your age or in proportion to your FSH levels, if you're producing an unusually large egg number, once again, either for your age or for your FSH levels, but the quality of those eggs is not great, and therefore also the embryo quality is not great, think about this diagnosis. If you have autoimmune problems, if you know that you have an autoimmune disease, or if in the past you had some autoimmune abnormalities in your blood, think about this diagnosis, because autoimmunity is very highly associated with this condition in a statistical way. And finally, the diagnosis is made if your androgen levels, especially your testosterone levels, are low, and your sex hormone binding globulin, SHBG, is high. If you have one or more of these symptoms, and you and your doctor haven't yet been able to pin down why you're not getting pregnant, despite multiple IUI and IVF cycles, think about hypoandrogenic PCOS.